That's a clip from a Japanese commercial for Gummy Sour Candies, a taste experience that is obviously akin to being chased by a giant turtle.
So what's the deal with this sour taste anyway? Let's explore the science behind it.
Sour is an interesting taste. We encounter it in fruits and pickles, but it's also the stuff of sour milk. By degrees and in combination with other flavors, it can prove delicious, disgusting, or downright exciting to a candy-craving kiddo.
It's arguably the most powerful yet least understood of our flavors. Researchers are still working to identify the molecules that contribute to sour taste, but essentially you can think of it as your tongue's pH detector.
Each primary taste triggers gustatory receptors across the tongue. See, each taste bud contains around 50 different cells that respond to all primary tastes. For sour-detecting cells, it's the pH level in a food that sets off our sour sensation. Such as the low pH acidity of lemons, oranges, and other citrus.
Check the ingredients on the back of your favorite sour candy, and you'll likely note ingredients like malic acid, citric acid, and ascorbic acid.
Acids release protons, but scientists have long puzzled over how protons actually activate the taste system. In a 2010 study from the University of Southern California, neurobiologist Emily Liman expected to find these protons binding to the outside of cells and opening pores in the membrane, which would then allow sodium to enter the cell.
Once inside, the sodium would send an electrical response to the brain, producing the experience of sour. But that's not what Liman actually discovered. Instead, she observed protons directly entering the cell and causing the electrical response.
And of course, this all makes perfect sense. If our sour taste depended on sodium, then how would our sense of taste detect sour in the absence of saltiness?
Where will these scientific excursions into the science of sour take us? According to Liman, it will open the door to even greater manipulation of flavor.
And who knows, maybe we'll breed a species of giant turtles in the process.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to check out these three videos as well.
And don't forget to visit us at stufftoblowyourmind.com.
Artificial flavors are simply chemical mixtures that mimic a natural flavor in some way.
Have you ever seen a cat and gone, "Hey, can you taste sweet things?" That's a weird question, but here's the answer. No.
So, if you're a lover of hot sauce, is it because you like the taste, or because you're a pepper junkie hooked on a feeling?